Nas leaving the spot. We in Miami tonight. My man C-webb on the camera from DC. He looked out for a young brother that was getting ready to get murdered by some other young brothers. But if them young brothers knew the truth about who's trying to murder all of us, we wouldn't even want to kill each other.
You got yourself a gun.
C-Wave to the team. The handguns kill. Kill people. Stop the violence. This is what's causing all this death in DC. Put these guns down, folks.
Yeah. Got yourself a gun.
Yo, I'm living in this time behind enemy lines, so I got mine, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
You from the hood, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
You want beef, hope ya.
Yeah.
And when I see you, I'ma take what I want, so you try to front, hope ya.
That's crazy that you knew these people, man. It's real, man. Ain't nobody else doing this, dog. People with billions of dollars, ain't nobody doing this, man.
It ain't no way, you know what I'm saying? We the strongest. Yeah. Survival of the fittest. You make it in here, baby. You can do anything.
Exactly.
I love you, boy.
I love you too, Chris.
All right, baby.
Your man.
This true to life account captures the most violent crimes that took place on the streets of DC during the 80s, the 90s, and present. This historical, critical acclaim video book memoir was created when DC was labeled as the murder capital of the world. A time when DC's notorious hitman Wayne Silk Perry was terrorizing communities with numerous murders, when the shotgun stalker was driving around and shooting and killing innocent people. The stories depicted throughout the book are truly amazing. The gangs in the community allowed the author, Curtis E. Mozie, aka C-Webb, to have unprecedented access to intimately explore their violent and brutal underworld. Kevin Barrett, The Washington Post. In Mozie's work, here's a reality program that might actually save some kids' lives. Chris Berry of ABC News Nightline. In the midst of silence, a voice speaks out.
Now, what black person you know got an income?
Take the journey into the world of C-Webb and his safe house as he artfully captures the deceitful candidness of everyday city kid life.
You know they're headed for the safe house.
In a relaxed way, they open up to Curtis' camera, voicing aspirations of existence in the language of basketball talk, fatherhood products, or just by freestyle rapping and
science.
Beyond the yellow tape, life and death on the streets of D.C.
Then suddenly, over time, these young men were being gunned down in the streets, becoming casualties of gang violence. Many were shot multiple times. Some were crippled for life, never to walk the streets again.
Beyond the Yellow Tape, the historically, critically acclaimed book memoir created by Curtis Mozie, aka C-Webb, a true-to-life account of the most violent crimes that took place on the streets of D.C. during the 80s, 90s, and at the present.
Stop playing, man. Come on, girl. We gotta go home, man. We gotta go home. Ben! Daughter!
You feel how I put it together?
I cried, man.
I put it together
C-webb,
like that.
C-webb safe house interviews change from dreams of hope to them predicting their own non-existence.
Man, you might act like you faking
or murder scenes.
Omega, I want to hear that.
I'm gonna make it, dog.
You gonna make it.
I can't say I'm gonna make it, but I done did some bad shit.
No, I'm gonna make it.
Forgotten names.
People that just got shot. Make it, dog.
Oh, so you ain't gonna put my cousin.
Just the number and statistic. So they called on Curtis
oceans
to record them.
Apart, day after day.
If I die, I want a nigga to be like, man, yeah, that was my homie. I grew up with the nigga. Like,
point. Just rest in peace. Don't nobody mess with me, you know?
That's gonna be a big secret.
Whatever happened, it just happened. It's my time to go. It's my time to go.
I see you next to never. But how can we see?
I mean, I'm a grown dude, but I'm proud, man. I'm emotional. You know what I'm saying? That just put you through emotion.
With no restraints, I show the nature of gang life as seen from DC's emergency room, where doctors strategy work to save thousands of lives. I captured the involuntary direct expressions of the families in prison in a cycle of murders, seemingly without cease, overcome with grief.
About who's trying to kill all of us young black motherfucking niggas, we would never aim a gun at each other. That's real.
Unable to curtail feelings, crying over the bodies of dead loved ones, doctors couldn't save.
Go. Your loss, Ms. Marshall. I'm praying for you. Rest in peace, Delonte.
Try, they've been killing us for 500 years.
500 years, we gotta stop, huh?
We're killing young niggas.
Anyway.
So, how you feel with what I'm doing? How you feel about what I'm doing now?
I love what you're doing because the work you're doing is pure, it's genuine.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Ain't like niggas paying you $1 million to do this shit. You deserve $100 million for what you do.
Sure, but it's on the streets of Washington, D.C. causing death. Why is it here? How these guns get over there?
Hey, do see where they shoot.
Yeah,
you better go ahead, okay, see where.
Okay. When after I watched the tape, I felt like I knew Dayday. It's sad that he lost Dayday, but hopefully his story of Tom and his family will keep many other Daydays alive. Hopefully. That story, when you see it, will keep a lot of young brothers alive who may not have been alive because of that story, because it touched your heart. And
ain't nobody paying you $1 million every time you pick up no fucking camera.
Dre, shot and killed. And 7th and Northwest. He served many streets beef, but fell victim from his own hood.
Whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes.
Marshall, my condolences to me. Rest in peace.
Right
Day, rest in peace. on it, cause your heart fucked that blood of a slave, heart of a king, nigga.
Hello.
That's what the black man.
And I saw his first film, which, you know, I mean, he's got some powerful stuff on
him. Yes.
And his voice needs to be heard beyond just here and in Washington, D.C. It really needs to be heard nationally. But the same problems he's documenting, the same problems happening in urban areas all across this country. And it's people like Curtis that will bring that to the light. We'll start doing something about it. So Curtis, thank you, man.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My son, I love him like crazy, and I miss him.
You miss him like crazy.
I miss my baby, and I wish he was here with me. All the time, I wish he was here.
He with us. He ain't gonna never die. He always with us.
And I say,
he always with us.
And go ahead, and I'm saying to the world, do what? Because he wasn't a bad kid, he's a good kid. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? He's a good kid. And you know what? I know I know, hold on, I know what I like about you.
He's a good. He's right here right now with us.
You're a good human being, and you do the right thing in this community. And they need more folks like you in this community, the soul community, because you do the best you can to save these Black American children. You help the kids the right way, and we need more people like you in this your community. You're a good person, and believe me, in God's name, you'll be so blessed.
Thank you.
You're going to be so blessed. You don't know what God got in the sky and the crown for you, because you're a good person.
You're
the one to do for everybody around here. And I wish one day, when I'm able, and all of us get together from Washington, D.C., get together and do something for you. Because you deserve something. Because you out here, you trying to keep the kids together. You do the best you can for our community. And I love you dearly. And I hope you be so much blessed in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
You do. You's a good person. It's not all about seven. It's not all about eight. It's not all about six. It's not all about fifth. It's not about the community. What about you? What about what you do for this community? One for you, have this stuff won't be stopped. One for you, where are these kids to be at? You understand what I'm saying? What about you? Oh, sometimes about you. What you doing for the recreation center? What you do for the kids? You do the lot for Black America. You do a lot for 7th Street community. What about you? That's what I'm saying. You understand what I'm saying? I'm telling you, you're a good person. I wish God brought everybody in the world like you. This world would be fighting, stabbing, shooting. Everybody be in school. Everybody be building themselves in the world. But don't ask the kids, where are these kids going to be at? Nowhere. No doggone where. And thank you.
Thank
in Jesus' name. And you're going to have so many blessings in your life. I might not be here, I might not be here tomorrow, but it might be an old woman. When God bless you, you'll say, Barbara told me, and you have a blessed one.
You too. Thanks a lot.